Meanwhile, a great change was taking place in the life of Mother Veronica. She felt increasingly drawn to the life of Carmel. The still, small inner voice was telling her,
"I want you in Carmel. I want you in Carmel."
"I have deliberated over your request and reached the conclusion that a third order of Carmel can be started, as a Carmel for the missions would be very desirable. A combination of contemplation with action."
"Thank you, my lord. I knew I could count on your support."
"The time has come for you to bid adieu to Saint Joseph of the Apparition and begin the third order of Carmel to serve in the missions. I assure you of my wholehearted support."
"Thank you, my lordship."
"Welcome, sister."
And thus began a new chapter in Mother Veronica's life. She got busy in establishing the third order of Carmelite sisters to work actively outside the cloister for the missions. In all her obedience and humility, Mother Veronica of the Passion submitted wholeheartedly to God's will. Little by little, one step at a time, God was preparing the way.
God, in His divine grace, supplied the courage and spiritual strength to Mother Veronica in her lone quest to establish a convent for the missions. Providence leads people through winding paths. Mother Elias of Carmel of Pope in France agreed to admit her into Carmel to imbibe the Carmelite spirit. On 15th of June 1867, Mother Veronica reached the Carmel of Pope, where she was welcomed with open arms. Mother Elias herself helped her not only in adjusting the life of Carmel, but also in planning and formulating her future work. This was where God had so insistently summoned her, and now she was at home. But only for 6 short months.
She was, after all, not destined to be a cloistered nun, but the foundress of an active order. When the call came for her to leave the cloister, she obeyed and was now a nun without a convent. As she tread the path of loneliness, trials, and untold miseries, it seemed that Mother Veronica's song had ended before it had scarcely begun. She was heartbroken, both in soul and body. She was laughed at, blamed, ridiculed at not being able to find a place to start a new congregation. The trials and tribulations around her created a deep conflict within her. Her search took her to many places, and finally to Bayonne, where subsequently the Carmel for Missions was established. In dire poverty and amidst untold hardships, Mother Veronica trained the sisters for India. In 1870, from the Carmel of Pau and the Little Carmel at Bayonne, sisters were chosen to initiate and establish the Apostolic Carmel in India.
blessings, my support, and my prayers.
Thank you, Mother. I request you to bless each one of us.
Of course. May God and Mother Mary bless you, Sister Elias.
Thank you, Mother.
May God and Mother Mary bless you, Sister Mary Lusand.
Thank you, Mother.
May God and Mother Mary bless you, Sister Mary Joseph.
Thank you, Mother.
Farewell, children.
Farewell, Mother.
Bye-bye, Mother.
Bye, Mother.
In November 1817, the Apostolic Convent was established at Mangalore in India. However, God's work had yet to endure the test of human frailty. Mother Veronica was forced to close down the house at Beyond, and she re-entered the Carmel of Poor at 50 years of age. For the rest of her life, she served God in the obscurity of the cloister and continued to water the tiny sapling that was transplanted in India with her prayers and sacrifices. Her spirit remained undefeated and undaunted till the very end.
This is the spirit for which the Apostolic Carmel has continued to strive.